the Nexus 9 got rumored around last week on AndroidPlace.com and nothing got announced yet. So let's jump what we know till date about the device. It's going to be manufactured by HTC, as well as we know that HTC is not really deep in the tablet segment and all. So the last tablet was around HTC was the Flyer back in 2011, and now the Nexus 9 is codenamed Volantis. They are coming back in the market. So let's first talk about the specs. So they leaked on the website, starting with the processor, is debuting NVIDIA Tegra K1 called Logan. It's going to be 64-bit architecture processor. The Tegra K1 is based on the Kepler GPU architecture, the same one seen in the NVIDIA's GeForce cards, and the Tegra K1 is sporting a single SMX unit with corresponding to 192 CUDA cores. All the cores are fully programmable and can operate parallelly. Epic Games shown their power with the K1 with Unreal 4 engine demo at I/O with the Tidal library. Delayed Nexus devices are getting named based on the screen sizes. So yeah, the screen size is a 8.9-inch display and 2048x1440p, that is consisting 281 pixel per inches with their density. We haven't got information about that. It's going to be IPS or AMOLED. So just can't say about the colors, but the resolution wise it's better than Apple's own iPad Retina display, and really excited to check the display out, because with the 1200p screen is kind of amazing on the Nexus 7, and so does the aspect ratio. It's not 4:3 at Nexus 9, but the touchscreen buttons will take place on this device, and probably it will become a 4:3 aspect ratio. In the memory segment, it's rumored to be around 2GB of RAM, and internal storage is going to be 13 or 16GB. So there is no information about it's going to support an external storage or not, and going to get a 64 modem. So this device is going to be a full aluminum body or aluminum zero gap construction is what they say on the box side of the device. It sounds kind of like HTC One. So talking of HTC One, there is the part which got me really pumped up for the device. It's going to feature boom sound front facing stereo speakers that we see on HTC One devices. So that will be just amazing. You can just imagine a tablet with boom sound speakers. So yeah, that will be just brilliant. So where are the speakers in the picture? So either the picture is not accurate or something, because the laser grid holes on boom sound speakers are visible at all the time, and with the time we will know that what is the real design of this tablet or where are the speakers. So the last thing that rumored were the prices of different models. So the Wi-Fi only or the non-LTE versions will be coming for $399 and $499 for 16 and 32 gig respectively. The LTE version will cost $600+, and that is the non-realistic part, because $100 to get LTE, who's going to buy that? And the camera are specified to be 8 megapixel optical image stabilization shooter at the back and the 3 megapixel camera on the front. They didn't specify the recording resolutions or something like that. So I think in the software category it will come with Android L pre-installed in the box, or the KitKat 4.4.4 or whatever the latest at that time will be, and going to be upgraded to Android L within a specific time, because it's a Nexus device and Nexus device always get the latest Androids out in the market. So yeah, this device is coming this fall, and so does Android L. So yeah, nothing more to predict about this device. Please let me know in the comment section what do you guys want from the device and what are you expecting. Thanks for watching. Liking or disliking is your personal preference. Subscribe to see more stuff like this in the future. Till then, take care, and I will meet you guys in the next one.